So our next speaker is a person who actually was involved in this process since start. When I met Dr. Eman in King Salman Hospital, I saw her conviction that the diabetes and its complications can be improved and can be cured. And that really increases our commitment to this process. Dr. Eman from King Salman Hospital will be talking on prevalence and prevention of diabetic foot in Saudi Arabia.
Assalamu alaikum. Thank you for the organized committee to invite me. It's really my pleasure to be with you, and also I know most of them from other centers. We hope that we can do some things too. What I found is really recently I was in Jubail in the Royal Commission Hospitals. And you know that I found a large group of patients with young and adolescents, and they have diabetes. When I saw them, I remember one girl, 23 years, and she's diabetic since her childhood, and now she's with on wheelchairs with charcoal foods. I cannot believe it, that's 23 years on wheelchairs because of the charcoal and the complications. And I found many also, they have ischemic legs and some they poorly manage, and some they go to the mom for another vascular intervention. So it's really the diabetes is increasing and the complications coming now. With our young children, that they start to have this complication of diabetic foot and the complication of charcoal. Just to remind you guys about what's our problem with diabetes in kingdom. We'll start with the overall, then we'll go to our kingdom. So in the IDF, the last editions, they think the diabetes is low. And you know that in 2015, one in 11 adults, they have diabetes. Expected to. In 2040, one in 10 will have diabetes. Not only that, and 2015, we have 318 million people with diabetes at high risk of diabetes. By 2040, we have 480. In total, will be that's for diabetes undiagnosed, and that we will have 2015. We have more than 730 million. Expected to have more than, I cannot read the numbers. It's more than 1 million that we have diabetes. So that's also, this is the last edition of the IDF. They did the one new case every 3 seconds. Not only that, one this every 6 seconds, and one limb lost every 20 seconds. So you can imagine. So now we are here, that's one limb lost. Every 20 seconds, there is one limb lost. Not only that, the death. This is high death rate from diabetes, and not the dysphonic. Those patients is not elderly, less than 60. The mortality rate is high among the diabetes with the age less than 60. And if we compare it to the other disease, like TB, HIV, and malaria, we are in the top. And you see the number of people with diabetes increasing. What's our the situations in the Gulf States? In the Gulf States, we are the same. There is a clear epidemiological evidence that the incidence high in Arab country, especially in the Gulf area. If you go to the Gulf area, we are the top among those area. What about, especially in Saudi Arabia, what we have? The alarming prevalence of diabetes in Saudi Arabia has been called an epidemic by many studies. So we are in an epidemic state. If you go to the, we started from a tiny study till the last study with the NUSHA, we started with the prevalence with 4.5. Till 2004, we have the prevalence with 23.5, 0.7. And there is another mini study by Rubian. But this is, when Dr. Rubian published this study, many people, they thought that the diabetes prevalence is decreased. No, because this is the total population. So the total population was 14% in the study of the Rubian. Then in 2009, another study came into saying that the overall rate is 30%. Then another study by Dr. Nasser Al-Dagri, and he's mentioned clearly, is the overall age adjusted prevalence for type 2 diabetes was 31%. Now I can say, compared with us, we are 1 in 3, we have diabetes. Before, 1 in 4. Now, 1 in 3 diabetic. So that's the prevalence or the incidence rate increasing by 1 year by 1%. Internationally, should be increased 1% every 10 years. But in Saudi Arabia, 1% every 1 year. So it is clearly shown by the studies. So what our MOH, Ministry of Health, they did a big survey about the diabetes. And there is very interesting findings. It's increasing by age. So the age, any patient more than 65, the prevalence of diabetes is almost 50%. Any more than 65, 1 in 2. And this is, it's not the number, it's the overall number of diabetic among the age more than 50, at 13.4. What about the cost? It's published about the cost of diabetes in Saudi Arabia, and they found diagnosed diabetes is cost about 17 billion. If you add the patient with undiagnosed, we add another 10 billion. If we add the patient with pre-diabetes become diabetics, so you can see how much it will cost. So the net result, they said, it's about more than 37 billion it will be cost in the future for a patient with diabetics. What is the risk factors for the diabetic foods? You know that. It's very common to have a patients, we found in our center, patient newly diagnosed type 2 diabetes, referred from the primary health care, we found more than 30 to 40% they have peripheral neuropathy, and which is the risk, very important risk factors for diabetic foods. So the risk factor is peripheral neuropathy, other things, peripheral vascular disease, past history of foot ulcers, other long-term complications. We found many patients with end-stage renal failure, they are liable more to have diabetic foot. And the deformity, and other things, the poor social economy. I will mention this later. And you know the role of 15%. 15% of diabetic patients, they have foot ulcer in lifetime. 15% of foot ulcer, they will go to osteomyelitis, and 15% of foot ulcer, they will have, unfortunately, amputations. And that was the rule of 50 for amputations. 50% of the amputation, transhumeral or transphyseal. 50 of patients, they have the second amputation less than 5 years. And this is very important. Once we have a patient with diabetic foot and amputation, so there is a chance to have the another limbs more than 50%. And not only that, and 50% of patients who have amputation, they die in less than 5 years. Also, the mortality is very high among the patients with the amputations and foot ulcer. I think one time we arranged to a patient to shift here for vascular interventions. While we're preparing these things, the patient died. Because it's a vascular problem. Every second, they told you, somebody dies from diabetes, and every 20 seconds, someone amputated. 25 of those with diabetes will develop 50 foot ulcers. More than half of all foot ulcers will become infected, requiring hospitalization, and 20% of infection result in amputations. This is about the mortality. The relative 5 years mortality rate after limb amputation is 68 when compared with the cancer. See, we are coming as a cancer. So number one is lung cancer. We are coming for the mortality in diabetic foot is 68. People with a history of diabetic foot ulcer have 40% greater 10 years mortality than people with diabetes. This is another study. Having a wound immediately doubles one's chance of dying at 10 years compared with someone without diabetes. In general, we are saying a patient with diabetes without complications minus 6 years for the mortality. And with the heavy complication, minus 12 years. So what is the burden of diabetic foot? In the United States, the cause of 50% of all non-traumatic amputations. 50% amputation per year. 3 year mortality in 50%. What's the burden of diabetic foot in Saudi Arabia? Actually, we didn't have enough data. Dr. Shamil Kandi, he said that's our next step, the research and the education about, and we want to collect up our data and achieve the others. So what we have in 1993, a telephone survey carried out and all hospitals of Riyadh showed that in one day in Riyadh, there is 36 amputations due to diabetes. A registry-based survey in Makkah was done by Dr. Khaled Tayyib, and it shows about 50 cases of amputation per month. Diabetes-related lower limb extremities, amputation in Saudi Arabia. This is by Professor Hassan Al-Zahrani in Jeddah, and he mentioned clearly, it's estimated that 325 amputations are likely to be performed in Jeddah compared to 741 in Riyadh. So based on this data, the current data, it can predict that more than 1,700 major amputations are performed annually in Saudi Arabia. So what about diabetic foot in Arab courts? Actually, if you see, most of them, they say it's lack of the data. What about our area? In Saudi Arabia, this based on Dr. Nusha's study, that's in 2004. I think the rate is more than this. He mentioned this study about diabetes, 23.7, and about the neuropathy, about 13%, and about the ulcer, is 13% amputation, and peripheral vascular disease, 0.2. And this one, The peripheral neuropathy, 13.7, diabetic foot, 4.3, and amputation, 1.9. It does, according to the study of Anuza in 2004. I'm sure that this number is higher by the last study by Dr. Dagri. We did in our center small study about the risk of foot ulcers. We check for the neuropathy. We involved more than 216 patients, and we found among those 216, 25% they have peripheral neuropathy. And when we compare for a risk to have foot ulcer, 18.5 of all those patients, they are risk to have foot ulcer. What is the risk factor for Arab world? Number one, weather. We are in an area with a hot weather. So hot weather, that's mean dry weather, and the other things, the use of the suntan. Habits. Still till now, we still this habit, walking barefoot. Religions. This is good or not good, is plus minus. That's we have to wash our 5 times for the prayers. Educations. Patient information about diabetes and its complication is still devolving. High preference of illiterate and all patients. Really, still we have this number of patients. Some of our visitors, they said, you need also not to improve your care service, you need public education. We need education for our people with diabetes. Media. 100%. We are poor in health education in media. What we are doing in media, actually, what they do, that's the medical errors. They are mentioning in the media, but not mentioning the positive thing they need to help the patient. So our media is really lacking for awareness of diabetes and the complications. Traditional medicine. Still till now, I have one patient, is educated. university graduate, and when you have the diabetic foods, he started with cutlery. So cutlery is still herb medicine, still they are using. You know, one patient admitted in Chimesi for, they have a foot problem, a foot ulcer. And his son daily, he was putting the honey on this wound. He said, they don't know that. Because we believe the honey, it's a method of management. Surgery phobia. So whenever you tell the patient that we refer to the surgery, so there is a real problem. Because they didn't know. They don't know there is now, it's the surgery is really improved. Now we are doing limited amputations. Actually, in our hospitals, we are doing amputation, but it is limited amputations, not like before. Before 16 years, before I came to King Salman, really, one day I was looking for a patients with ulcers, diabetic foot ulcers, because we have some workshops. I didn't find. All patients admitted in King Salman amputated. It's either below knee or above knee amputations. But now, alhamdulillah, for the last 4 years, they know about them. The number of patients admitted to the hospital to diabetic feet almost to be zero. If the amputation done usually is not from our centers, coming from outside even Riyadh. And if we do amputation, it's limited amputations. And this is, should be public, they should know. There is something called limited amputations. Healthcare system. This is the problem, healthcare system. If you want to send the patient for me, if you go to the complicated system, you have to go to primary healthcare put into what you call ihala, then to refer to me. In our center, we accept any patient, Saudi or non-Saudi, if they have diabetic foot. But other center, I don't know what they are doing. But the system is poor. Healthcare providers, still in the primary health care, low awareness of the magnitude of the problem and the standard managements. Community factors, strong belief. They are belief in the traditional medicine, delayed presentation. Most of them, they do everything, then they come to us late. Rehabilitations. So if you do these amputations, you need rehabilitation, you need supports. And this is, again, is lacking in our country. In our communities. And this is the problems. Most of our male patients, they are using this kind of standard. And you know, this is just a case. This is a case report by Dr. Bernas. You guess what this patient treated by what? This is henna. So treated by henna, but alhamdulillah, he was came to, and this is the case reports. So what about awareness? Awareness of the foot self-care among Saudi diabetic patients referred to our centers. So what we found? Again, only 30% received foot self-care counseling after the diagnosis. Man, you know, this patient, most of our patients, when they diagnosed, should be in the primary health care. Only 30%. They have counseling about something about diabetic foot. 42 have excellent level of knowledge about the effects of diabetes on the foot health. 17 had a good ability to identify and apply appropriate foot care knowledge. And after giving the knowledge, only 17%. So it's not enough. You have to be sure that the patient understands and to apply the knowledge. And 10% have adequate foot care practice. So most of them, no adequate footwear products. They still, they they are not using appropriate. And 47 regard their foot care practice as inadequate. Conclusion of this study, they still need to, our primary health care and even their centers, they have to give more knowledge and more education about their adequate foot care. And you know better than me, but we need to do evaluating the good diabetic foods. We need to start with history, examinations, and classify the patient who have half a risk of diabetic foods. And you know, according and genetic. Actually, in our center, we have a forms just to categorize our patients. It's what's the risk factor to have diabetic foods. And then, the next step, if you have ulcer, we have two stages, infected or non-infected. The important thing is that infected, we know what's the password. or non-infected one, that we have to do the measures to decrease it. And you know from this table that when you go down, the risk of amputation is more. When you go that, once when you go in the horizontal way, that's the risk of the tip of the ulcer more. So what is the recommendation from American Diabetes Associations? Number one, perform comprehensive foot evaluations annually to identify the risk for ulcer and amputation. Please, all patients with type 2 diabetes, once come to you, send them for evaluation of the foods for the risk of the ulcer. Number two, all patients with diabetes should have their feet inspection at every visit. Again, this is our problems in our practice. We didn't inspect our patients with the foot. In some centers, I found that they should go to the clinic without shoes, just to see that if there is any problem with it. And we instruct our nurses, during taking the vital sign, they should see the feet. If they have any problem, just notify so to be seen by the doctors. History should contain prior history of ulcerations, amputation, Charcot foot, angioplasty, or vascular surgery, cigarette smoking, retinopathy, and renal disease, and should assess the current symptom of neuropathy and vascular disease. Just to tell you, sir, about the smoking. Maybe some of you believe that the female, they are not a smoker. I was in Rafah for some time. I found a patient. She's almost 60 years, and she has severe diabetic foot. And she went to many times to limited amputations. And she has that severe vascular disease, peripheral vascular disease. But really myself, I'm doubt. Usually I didn't find this vascular disease in the female. But just I asked her that you have some of your family smoking. But her son, he said, she's the one smoking. She's a heavy smoker. But among females, they are smokers. Same thing, they are smokers. But don't be shy from the female. If they have a peripheral vascular disease, think about the smoking. Examine should include inspection of the skin, assessment of the foot deformities, neurological assessment, and vascular assessment, including the pulses in the legs and feet. Please, 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 be sure about the examinations. Patient with symptom of claudications, this is where I'm here, that's decrease or absent beta blood should be referred for ABI and further vascular assessment, a multidisciplinary approach. I cannot do alone. I should work with teams. The use of specialized therapeutic footwear is recommended for a patient with high risk feet. Refer the patient who smoke or who have a history of lower extremity complication, loss of the protective sensation, structural abnormality, or peripheral vascular disease to the foot care specialist for ongoing prevention care and lifelong service. Please, sitters, you should have this things for the screening. All patients, type 2 diabetes, should be screened when they are first time coming in. Then, up to you to do it annually, to do it 6 months, according to the risk factors. Provide general foot self-care education to all patients with diabetes. So, we aim from, actually, from centers of diabetes centers, we have the nurse, we train them to how to care, and we train them to give some education during doing the examination and evaluations. And most of the centers, they have this monitoring. It's a simple test, just to do it to detect does the patient have neuropathy or not. Very simple. And the recommendation from the ADA, they said that just do this test if you need another test like vibration or reflex, whatever. But the important is this one, the 10 gram monofilament, just to we know that this patient have a risk of neuropathy or not. In conclusion, 500,000 of many countries are likely to have a minor or major diabetes-related amputations, according to the figure generated in the current state of KCA. The most of amputated will not be rehabilitated and may lose their job or income. This is another issue. Thus, we don't have a good rehabilitation or support. And a few of this national registry are urgently needed in our area to prevent or decrease the risk of amputations. Thank you.
Thank you, Dr. Eman.
Can I ask Dr. Sure. Eman a question? Dr. Eman, I have seen another also challenge that we always blame the patient and education and the media. But there are so many doctors, especially general surgeons, they have been trained this is a microvascular disease. They will never do vascular assessment. They don't believe in this revascularization business. They will go for, you know, high amputation right away. It's a major challenge, actually, because, you know, maybe can correct you. I have seen multiple examples where small toe had an ulcer and they were offered below the knee, and the surgeon, the general surgeon, will refuse even doing a Doppler. He said, no need. Sorry, I won't use experience and
Actually, you are right. Amputation below knee or above. Even after some patients are recruited or there is no chance for any treatment here in KSA, after that we thought or we said to the patient about amputation. And about microvascular or micro, really this is a small part of the problem of the diabetic. We are looking for the mainstream. Then after that, yes, but we nowadays we didn't go for that, but we now it is known you have to go to recanalize the main vessels and then you can go to small.
Well, thank you. To you, but and I have experience with others. I don't know, maybe and it can correct me, but I've seen other examples. I hope it will be like you, Sarah. This is a great thing to hear.
I am with you, Richard, because there is some hospital, not you, I'm sure that you're not doing some. I come hospital. So we agree that, inshallah, we'll make it, because any amputation should go to board review, should be a committee before you do amputations. Committee that's including the general surgeon, the vascular surgeons, and the diabetic surgeon. They should, and the orthopedics, should be a committee. It's not a simple thing, sir. The decision, unless a patient is in shock or whatever, you want to do something else. But this is, if you have to think about amputation, should be a committee that decides this patient should go to amputations. Should be assist the vascular before to go to amputations. And even that's some, I'm sure that you are doing some, actually in our hospital, they're doing the amputations not the proper way. That's we found in one patient, they did the amputations, that's in the way that no way to give a support later on. But this is one you need also, you know, a few here in our kingdom, they know that's how to do the proper amputation. Later on, they can support with the devices and whatever.
Thank you, Dr. Rahman. Just to re-emphasize that diabetes prevention or amputation prevention program, or even amputation, it's a multi-systemic, multi-professional, multidisciplinary decision.